Welcome to Epic Elite Maze of Madness. I'm going to be using the wolf in this video. Don't usually use the wolf in Epic Elites, but he's really handy in here to get levers. I'm kind of warming up to the idea of using the wolf on Epic Elites. The wolf can be really squishy on Epic Elites, but if you're careful to make sure you're pulling aggro away from him, it can be some nice supplemental DPS. Just using regular ship buffs, not using any store buffs or anything unusual. You'd be able to complete this without using any pots. Couple of the cats blinded right now, so they're pretty much ineffective. Right now I got on the wolf I got the Thunderforged wraps turned into a collar. And they're just up to tier 2 right now. And let's see the abilities I got on them. I got the paralyzing, the greater paralyzing on them, which is nice. And then Touch of Flames, 10 to 60 fire damage. Got it slotted up with the Meteoric Star Ruby. So I'm just going to show you what kind of damage he's doing. Not a whole bunch, but it helps a little bit. And you can see the paralyzing is hitting even on Epic Elites, which is pretty cool. Here's the first spot you want to use your wolf to pull a lever for you. You know, you can use a hireling here too, or you can use like your Onyx Panther, Figurine of Wondrous Power, or your Owlbear too. Even though the gate came down on your wolf, you just call him through, he'll come right through it. With all the new buffs that came out with U22, it's upped my hit points a little bit. I'm sitting at 1309. And AC is up to 162. And it's a little bit higher if I were to use the old buffs that are still sitting in the cargo bay. I think it gets up to like 165. Make sure you deal with these shamans right away, otherwise they're just going to keep healing themselves and the other mobs. down the cats, the blinded cats, while you're beating up the boss. I've been asked many times, what do I use to hotkey selecting the wolf? And I really like to use the tilde key, because it's just right there. I don't really have to move my hand at all. And it's a key that I wasn't using for anything else before. It's nice and convenient. This is a nice quest to be able to solo, because you can farm for your Epic Elite Jeweled Cloak. One of the better spell absorption items in the game. If you're not familiar with it, it's got some slots. It's got a yellow and green slot. Really nice. Inherent elemental resistance 10 to all elements. And then 25 charges of spell absorption. Very nice for situational use. You can even actually wear it as a full-time cloak on some builds. So this can be kind of a scary quest to try to solo on some builds because of all the traps, but I'm going to show you that on this build it's not really an issue. I'm just going to stand in the traps. They're not going to do a whole lot of damage to you, even on Epic Elite. 82 damage, nothing to worry about. With this guy here, you want to pull him through. If you go in there, it's just going to spawn some extra mobs you don't need to deal with. There's no advantage to going in there. Now you need your wolf again to open up that gate there so you can get through to the lever around the corner, which will open up this gate here, and it's going to be one of these random levers. Okay. So now, down there, there's a gate that's closed. We gotta open that. This lever at the end of the hall. Call your wolf to you, tell him to hit it. And that's that. Call your wolf to you again. Thank you. grabs off of your wolf, otherwise he's going to go down really fast. You can just bring all the stuff in the next room. Put it all together. It's not really cooperating, so this'll just do. Make sure you take these mystics down right away again. It's really important that you stay on top of your wolf in terms of keeping the aggro off of him, the shrine when you need it, and not to let him die. It's a huge disadvantage to let your wolf die because you do lose hit points and spell points in DDO when your wolf dies. You know, it's garbage, but you know, it is what it is. There's nothing like that in pen and paper. I'm not sure why they did that here, but they did. Maybe 4th edition's like that, I don't know, I've played it, but nothing like that in the other editions. Always want to make sure you lock an examine window open on the bosses, because you don't want to start overwriting your own creeping colds. If you do that, you lose out on the big damage. First chest. he's gonna want to just fight this guy around the corner. Oh, I think there's some. Yeah, some Razor Cats that spawn here. I forgot about that. I am in water elemental form right now. It's sometimes there's some graphic bugs. It looks like I'm not in any form, but I am. You can see here the icon, the water elemental icon is lit up here. So right here, if you're not familiar, this, you know, one of these levers here is gonna open up this gate. And if you're ever in here on a build that, you know, you don't have a trapper and you don't want to get hit by those traps, you can, for a lot of these levers, step far enough away you won't get hit by anything. Like if you stand here, you can pull this first one. You shouldn't get hit by anything. I got hit. It should have been just a couple, like a half step to the left. And then with this one, you can stand like right here and pull this lever. Spot we need the wolf to pull levers for us. Make sure you're quick to intim those mobs off your wolf. Side here to pull the lever to avoid the traps if you want to. cats here, you could just drag them to the next fight, which is gonna be the final required fight. Then we'll go back and get the caster. After you put AoEs out here, it'll attract everything from inside the room. There's a shaman or two in there. You want to make sure that, you know, you keep an eye on them, because they may not come in here and they may just be healing everybody from inside the room. There he is in the back, kind of Forsworn Mystic. This guy's gonna cast Feeble Mind, and if he does that, you're not gonna be able to cast, which makes things a little more challenging. You wanna stay out of his Mind Fog, because that's going to lower your saves against the Feeble Mind. That. Look at the chest, and then we'll go get the caster optional. No jeweled cloak for me. Now you can perch and do the caster if you want. I think it's easier just to go down. And you want to try to get him, you know, immobilized with Earthquake or something, or blinded right away, because if you just sit there and let him cast on you, he can be kind of a pain. as I was saying, getting knocked down while in Stand Against the Tide stands is very frustrating. But that's what happens right now. And the cyclonic blast that he does, or gust of wind, I'm not sure which one, I think that was cyclonic blast, that's knocking me down. That also blows out the AoEs, so that's what I'm saying. You gotta get him down really quick if you can, otherwise, obviously, you saw he got me pretty low, and if he's knocking you down, there's not really a whole lot you can do. Thanks for watching. If you got any questions about the build, feel free to send me a tell if you're on Sarlona, or you can respond to my forum post.